Hello, my dear children. This is the last module of this class, that is aggregate functions. So far we discussed about only single row functions. Here aggregate functions will group the columns for getting result. We are going to discuss about aggregate functions. Aggregate function is used to perform calculations on group of rows and return the calculated summary like sum of salary, average of the mark, count of number of students, maximum value within a column, minimum value within a column, like that. The available aggregate functions in MySQL are sum, AVG, count, max, min and count star. Look at the example. Consider a table, employee, with the following structure. Max function is used to find the highest value among the given set of values of any column or expression based on the column. The max takes only one argument, which can be either a column name or any valid expression involving a particular column from a table. Look at the example given. Select max of salary from the employee table. Without seeing the output, we can easily say it is 8,000. So you will get the result as max of salary. Coming to the next example, minimum. It is very simple, just opposite to minimum value. The compiler will take the minimum value from the given column along with the min. So select min of salary. So always we need to enclose the column name within brackets if you are using any functions in SQL like string function, math function, date or time functions or aggregate functions. We need to enclose column name in brackets. So you will get 4,500 as the minimum salary. Coming to the sum of salary, it's nothing but the total value of any column or expression based on a column. It accepts the entire range of values as an argument, which is to be summed up on the basis of particular column or an expression containing that column name. The sum function always takes argument of integer type only. Sum of string and date type are not defined yet. So if you are giving the query like this, it will add 5000 plus 4500 plus 6000 plus 700 sorry 7200 plus 8000. You will get 30,700 as a result. This comment on execution shall return a total of salaries of all employees from the specified column salary of the table employee, which is 30,700. Coming to the average function. Average function is used to find the average of any value in a column. Like sum, it also accepts the entire range of values of a particular column to be taken average of, or even a valid expression based on this column name. The average function always takes argument of integer type only. The string type and the date type data is not defined yet. Look at the average salary of that is given. For Ritu Jane, it is null. For Lena Aurora, it is null. So what will be the average salary? How the count happens, or how you got 6,140? The compiler will take only 4,500 plus 6,000 plus 8,000. The sum of 4,500 plus 6,000 plus 8,000 divided by 3 only, because all the next, the other values are 2. The two values are null. The other two values are null. So it will take only 3 for the denominator. Even though the table having 5 employees, 2 of the employee having only null values. So the compiler will take only 3 as the denominator for finding the average. Usually the compiler will eliminate the null values. Count function. The count function is used to count the number of values in a column. Takes the argument, which can be any column name or an expression based on the column, or an asterisk. When the argument column is a name column or an expression based on the column, it returns the number of non-null values in that column. Non-null values in the column. So look at count star from employee. So it will count the first column. It will count the first column and will return. If the argument is asterisk, that count stands the total number of records, rows satisfying the condition, if any in the table. It won't count for any null value if you are giving star. So count star. So we will get 5. If you are giving distinct of city, so it will select the city Delhi, Jaipur, Kanpur, Bangalore. The Kanpur is repeated. So if you are giving count of distinct of city, so the compiler will do the function distinct of city at first. Distinct of city at first, that is Delhi, Jaipur, Kanpur, Bangalore, so that we will get only 4 counts. My dear children, as I said earlier, how the sum of salary, min of salary, max of salary, count of salary and average, and count star will execute, it is given in a slide. Consider the following table: employee with null values against the salary field for the same some employees. None of the aggregate function takes null into consideration. Null values are simply ignored by all the aggregate functions, as clearly shown in this example given below. The sum of salary. The compiler will avoid null values. Min of salary. Again, the null values are avoided, not considered. Max of salary, it avoids or ignore the null values. Min of salary also. Count of salary, we will get only 3, because even though 5 employees are there, 3 employees are getting the salary, other 2 having only null values. So the compiler automatically ignores null value. The average, it will be calculated as 18,500 divided by 3 only. The sum divided by total number of records, which are 3 after ignoring null values. Select count star from employee, then only you will get 5, because count star always consider null values. Count star, it will take the first column only at first. Dear children, I think you are all clear about how the aggregate functions works. The only thing you have to remind in your mind is null values are ignored by the compiler when we are applying aggregate functions. Aggregate functions are also known as multiple row functions or group functions, because it groups the column with the multiple rows. Whereas string function, math function and data and time functions are called single row function, because it takes only single row for calculations. Thank you.